YouTube. Welcome to my channel, Anne at Bella, and today I'm reviewing Doctor Who Series 13 Flux Chapter 4. We are more than halfway through now. Village of the Angels. Oh my goodness. Chapter 4. OMG. Absolutely love this episode. This episode is high. I'm going to give it 5 stars purely because we had a reference to the Third Doctor with the neutron flow. We had reference to Ghostlight, which is one of my absolute favourite Seventh Doctor stories. We had a professor in this. There was just so many good things. The Weeping Angels were fully utilised. OMG, loved it. Also, the division, which I will get to. Do not worry, we're going to put that to the side for now. I'm loving the fact that we have still got the Belle story going all the way through. I'm loving this. Her storyline is brilliant. And the Vinda storyline. Beautiful, absolutely loving that. Also, I'm really, really loving the Dan and Yaz team. That is working so well. I'm also loving the fact that they got the correct attitudes of toxic masculinity, for want of a better term, in this episode, reflecting in the time period. Brilliant use. Loved it, loved it, loved it. The Weeping Angels, creepy as. And getting creepier. That fire one. Oh, and then angels coming out of the ground. Awesome. Just brilliant. And the use of a drawing and a TV. The special effects in this were brilliant. Loved it. The Doctor, compelling. Isn't this brilliant? Loved it. Love the three-way split. It is really happening and it is happening fast. And aren't those two creatures with the crystals really creepy? I'm a passenger. I'm so getting Black Guardian vibes, even if it's not the Black Guardian. So many classic Who things happening here. Also, earlier in the episodes, like chapter one, we had Nitro 9 mentioned, and again in, I think it was either 3 or 2, it got mentioned. Ah, Seventh Doctor vibes, companion ace. Anyway, moving on. All good things, good performances, good CGI, good storyline. The writing in this episode was tight. It was so nice to finally find out what happened to Claire. OMG, very exciting stuff. Loved it. Loved it, loved it, loved it. On to what is the division, and this connects very nicely with the Timeless Child storyline and beyond. The division was mentioned briefly, very briefly in Classic Who. There are some old Classic Who fiction books about the division. I believe there's the House of Lungborough, which is about the Doctor's Time Lord house, where the division is mentioned. Obviously not the Timeless Child thing, that's kind of like a new concept, but it's a concept that's sort of been echoing. We've kind of had hints and traces. What is the division? We kind of know more about it since Chris Chernobyl has fleshed it out a bit, when we had that wonderful episode where that child got sent down to that village and he was there to do like police work. And that's basically what the Doctor, like the Doctor Ruth, is one of the Doctor's many forms, where he's been sent, memory wiped, and then utilized as like basically a space and time policeman, but for the Time Lords. And then there's the division, or the Central Intelligence Agency. The Master may or may not have worked for them, or he may have found out that the Timeless Child was used this way. We're not quite sure. And then his Doctor, the Timeless Child's Doctor form, as we know from William Hartnell to Jodie Whittaker, is the form that had a, we want to say, normal Time Lord experience, for want of a better reason. So we don't exactly know why, but I've long suspected, ever since Valedicium, which is the, or the parting of the ways, or whatever it is called for the 10th Doctor, where you've got his mother going like that in a very, very weeping angel pose, and Timothy Dalton's president says that we will stand in shame like the weeping angels of old. That's how far we're going back. It's all starting to connect, even when we had Cybermen dressed in Time Lord clothing. It's all linking up. There are threads here, and this is really important going forward. Whatever this is, it is all connected up with that, and I'm loving the fact. What is a rogue weeping angel? Can you even have them? Apparently you can. Who is it? Is that the master in Weeping Angel form? Because I've got my own theory about the Weeping Angels. I believe that they are lost Time Lords in the Time War that have become Weeping Angels. That's just my theory, because they've got a lot of Artron energy, and that's what time travellers tend to accumulate, a lot of Artron energy. As the TARDIS once said, as when it was in its Idris form. So yeah, they feed on it, and they feed on your unlived life. But the people that they pick to send back tend to be unnoticeable yet significant to that particular time stream. There's a reason for it. Anyway, this is high speculation and theory. None of this has been proved or disproved. It is the highest level of Doctor Who theory. It has been debated about for years, and mostly decades. Yes, and it even goes back to episodes like The Five Doctors and various other things where they were looking at stone with writing on. It's all about the division. There are some early episodes where they send the Doctor on some kind of mission that is linked up with this, but he doesn't quite know. It's all a bit strange, but yes, it has always been there, like an echo or a shadow hovering over, very much like how the War Doctor, played wonderfully by the late John Hurt, actions was hanging over, like the Ninth Doctor, played wonderfully by Christopher Eccleston, by the way. Anyway, I've digressed, but I'm loving to see that Flux is very firmly rooted, and actually I'm really liking the fact that Chris Chernobyl has used Stephen Moffat's Weeping Angels to full effect, and they're deliciously cruel, absolutely deliciously cruel. Loving it. It's definitely a 5 out of 5 episode. I cannot wait for chapter 5. It is so exciting. The Survivors of the Flux. That'll be the penultimate. That's the one before the last episode. I can't believe it. We've only got 2 more episodes. The penultimate, the one before the last, and the last episode. And then we're going to have regeneration. This is high stakes, people. High, high stakes for the 13th Doctor in the 13th season. That's a lot of 13s. Anyway, like, comment and subscribe, and thank you so much, and stay safe where you are, and please do click on the notification bell. Thank you. Bye! I hope you have enjoyed my review of Doctor Who Flux Chapter 4, Village of the Angels. Please like, comment and subscribe, and do click the bell notification for when my new videos drop. Thank you so much, and stay safe.